In this lesson, we will model the product of two fractions using fraction bars. Looking at the table, in the first column we have the product, in the second column we'll sketch a model, in the third column we'll write the multiplication sentence or multiplication equation. The first product is 2/3 times 1/2, which means 2/3 of a copy of 1/2. Then we have 3/4 times 1/2, which means 3/4 of a copy of 1/2. And finally, we have 2/3 times 4/5, which means 2/3 of a copy of 4/5. To model the product, we'll begin by modeling the second fraction in the product. So for the first product, we'll begin with modeling 1/2. For the second product, we'll begin with modeling 1/2. And for the third product, we'll begin with modeling 4/5. So here we have the meaning of each product and the model for the second fraction in each product. Going back up to the first example, we have 2/3 times 1/2, which means 2/3 of a copy of 1/2. So because we went 2/3 of a copy of 1/2, we'll begin by dividing this 1/2 into three equally sized smaller pieces. And because we want to determine the value of 2/3 of 1/2 in relation to 1 whole, we'll also divide this piece into three equally sized smaller pieces. Now looking at 1/2, we want 2/3 of a copy of this amount, and therefore we shade two of these three equally sized smaller pieces. Notice each smaller piece is equal to 1/6 of 1 whole, and therefore this amount is 2 copies of 1/6, or 2/6, which means 2/3 times 1/2 is equal to 2/6. Now let's also compare this amount, but we can also simplify this fraction. Going back to the model, if we consider 1 whole, we can express this amount using larger pieces. Notice how one of the three equally sized pieces is shaded, and therefore this is equal to 1/3. So we can also write 2/3 times 1/2 equals 1/3. More traditionally, we can simplify 2/6 by dividing the numerator and denominator by 2, giving us a simplified fraction of 1/3. Next we have 3/4 times 1/2, which means 3/4 of a copy of 1/2. So because we went 3/4 of a copy of 1/2, we'll divide 1/2 into four equally sized smaller pieces. And we'll also do the same for the unshaded part, so that all the pieces are the same size. Now because we went 3/4 of a copy of 1/2, we would shade three of these smaller sized pieces that make up 1/2. Notice each small piece is equal to 1 copy of 1/8, and therefore we have 3 copies of 1/8 shaded, which shows the product is equal to 3/8. So 3/4 times 1/2, or 3/4 of a copy of 1/2, equals 3/8. We can see this fraction does not simplify because we cannot express this amount using larger sized pieces. 3/8 is in simplest form. And now for the last example, we have 2/3 times 4/5, which means 2/3 of a copy of 4/5. Because we went 2/3 of a copy of 4/5, we'll divide each piece in the model equal to 1/5 into three smaller equally sized pieces. Again, we'll do this for the shaded parts as well as the non-shaded part. I'm going to go ahead and highlight the original unit divided into five equally sized pieces. Now because you want 2/3 of a copy of 4/5, we'll shade two of the three equally sized smaller pieces that make up each 1/5. So we'll shade these two small pieces, these two, and these two. The shaded region represents 2/3 of a copy of 4/5. Notice how each small piece is equal to 1 copy of 1/15 of 1 whole. So because we have 2, 4, 6, 8 shaded pieces, we have 8 copies of 1/15, and therefore the product equals 8/15. So 2/3 times 4/5 equals 8/15. We cannot express this amount using larger pieces, which means 8/15 is simplified. More traditionally, this fraction is simplified because the only common factor between 8 and 15 is 1. I hope you found this helpful.